My background, so some of you don't know me, I'm a martial artist. I've been practicing martial arts for 25 years. I hold a rank of 7th degree black belt. I'm a former deputy sheriff of Chattanooga, Tennessee. I've also been in the military and served in the Middle East Desert Shield, Desert Storm. So basically, I've been halfway around the world and seen how other cultures, how they think, and how they respond to different things. And when you go over to other people's countries, you cannot think like an American. You have to adjust to them. If you've never been to any other country in your life, you need to try it. Do a mission trip somewhere, especially younger folk while you've got a chance. You need to go somewhere else, not here. Not looking at Newport, Chattanooga, but go somewhere else. Because y'all don't realize how thankful we are in this country. You know, I know we served our, recognized our Independence Day yesterday, and our family father will be turning over the grave what you see today. And I don't think they would want what our government is doing today. Part of my message is not too positive, it's instant positive. I want people to think about what's going on in our culture. That's why I call it a culture war in America. And our culture war is a spiritual war right now. Our country is completely split down the middle. Either you are a Christian or you're not a Christian. And there's those people who say they're Christians, but I don't know if they really are or not. You can come to church and be a good church member, doesn't mean you're a Christian. That's basically how I look at it. Now, the secular world, the atheists, the same Christians are trying to change the country. No. What Christians are trying to do is keep it the way it was before. That's what we're trying to do before it gets too far. All we have to do is look at Europe and see all the problems. That's about 20 years ahead of 20 years ahead. The way things are going is moving so fast in the past few months with our government. But whoever raises their voice the loudest in the culture changes the culture. If you're just coming to church to keep to yourself, guess who's going to win? The other guys. Christians have got to stand up. The biggest thing right now, if you're a Christian, you're a bigot, you're a homophobe, whatever. But Christians are being persecuted worldwide. We know that. I think most of us see the news at least a little bit. But when you're a Christian in the USA, maybe you are, maybe you're not. There's a lot of people that think they're Christians are not going to heaven. Okay, just keep that in mind. I think most of us know this. But when you're a Christian overseas, especially in a Muslim country, and let you know right now, I'm not a preacher, I'm a teacher. So I'm going to be talking to you like normal. I'm not going to scream your hair head off. But Muslim countries, if you're not a Muslim, and they find out you're a Christian, they're going to kill you. If they see it on your ID, you're a Christian, they shoot you down right on the spot. That's what they used to do in Lebanon, until they took the Muslims and over. So the Nation of Islam, I did that in Nashville last year with him. I'm not going to do those details today. I'm not going to go over details all day long on that, but I'm trying to understand how they think now. And so many Arab Christians come running to America. Well, this is the last country left, supposedly. But now, I don't know what's going to happen next. Unless we wake up and become Christians, like Christians are supposed to be, and stand up for what you believe in. We have to be Christians. We can't be liberal Christians. You can't be a gay Christian. It ain't happening. Okay? I'm not going to pull out the verses. But our cultural war examples, President Obama recently said we're no longer a Christian nation. And a lot of people from churches voted him in because they're not paying attention. Gay marriage approved already in 6 states and more on the way. The federal government's going to make states. I don't know. We better not. I'm going to move to Australia. But abortion, we've killed up to 50 million babies since it was legalized. This was a Christian nation. Now I'm kind of wondering if we really are. How would we set the example for other cultures if we're acting like we're acting, allowing our country to fall apart? And many false prophets, liberal churches, discounting parts of the Bible, you know, just letting it, whatever. Pray like this, and it's okay to be a gay priest. It's okay to do whatever you want to do. Just come to church and be happy. Okay? But that's what's tearing our culture apart. Pollard, especially, I would not want to be you guys right now, because y'all have more of a challenge now than probably I do, because of the culture shock and all the pressures y'all got to put up with. I would not want to be you, so y'all have to really work extra hard than probably my generation did. And we're going to pray for you. We're going to keep continuing to pray, because your generation, you're going to save yourself. Us old guys are getting old, and nobody, somebody's got to replace us. Who's going to replace the folks back there? Who's going to replace me? If your culture, if your age bracket, don't take up to the slack as we get older and to do it no longer. But hate crime, for example, is another culture, for example, charging for the same crime. Just also, if you kill somebody, they were charged against you the way you thought. They're charging twice for the same thing. So eventually, they're going to see pastors being arrested. Might somebody come right here and throw him in jail for preaching the gospel? Because homosexuality is sin, and that's considered a hate crime if they pass this new law. But there's only that far away right now. So just let you know about that. I hope some of y'all are hearing this on your own. I know this is negative. I'm just trying to be. We got to keep it straight. I'm to the point. I'm a little sarcastic sometimes. I'm not all serious. You know, just let you know for right now. But our people of the government, I mean of this nation, wants to be more dependent on the government. And I'm sure you heard this on Fox News. It's called socialism. And socialism doesn't work. Hitler, socialism. Stalin, socialism. Did it work for them? No. And people don't listen and read and look at what's going on. And the Bible says history does repeat itself. And it's repeating itself. Unless we can slow it down. And like Bishop Charles Bibb from my church, Omega Harvest Church, he's retired pastor. His daughter, Pastor Mia Pittman Head, is our pastor. We have a lady pastor. Some people don't agree with that. I can't find it in here, but she can't be one. So that's not my problem. I do what the Bible says. But we have to keep our minds awake, watch and pray, like the Bible tells us to do. Watch and pray. I'm going to show you a little, but we have to be for real. Okay, we can't be fake, bench warming Christians. All we take is milk, we don't know anything about the meat. That's the problem with many churches. Many churches have failed. That's why my church and many churches got empty pews, because God is not relevant. It's just, I don't have time. I got to go to college, I got to go to work. I'll give a violin now and say, Wayne, you know, probably maybe stuff. I don't want to hear it. Because many prophecies of the end times, I don't have this on my notes, have already been fulfilled. Israel has been a nation in 1948. They took their nation back. Jerusalem became a capital in 1967. So that's the capital. So many prophecies have been fulfilled. What's left? The rapture. If you're not ready to go, you will be left behind. And I'm sorry, halfway Christianity is not going to get you there. I'm just hoping in your true and heart that you really are a Christian. And only between, that's between you and God. You can fake me, fake everybody else. That's just between you and Him. He knows for real if you're truly a Christian or not. And one of my pet peeves is that keeps churches kind of, I don't know what the best way to say it, is denominations. Denominations is part of the problem. We got a Baptist, we got a Methodist, we got Church of God, we got a Catholic, we got the Mickey Mouse Club, we got the TBN. I don't know, we got so many different variations of the Bible, we don't know what to believe anymore. And people that don't are not a Christian, they're confused. They don't know what to think. And the true commentary is the Bible itself. You can probably find 500 different commentaries on that can explain this, but this is the true one. And I always, if I have a question, I go to my pastors that have been around a lot longer than me, the elders of the church. That's who I go to. So many states have recently renewed their 10th Amendment rights of sovereignty. In Tennessee, it is February 18th, 2009. That means if the government continues to do what it's doing, or to say to pull away like they did before the Civil War.